Hey, welcome back. Let's talk about how to upgrade your virtual presentations through your equipment. We got to talk about lighting. So I'll show you three different levels of lighting that I use. First off, the basic, the easy is the ring light. You can get one of these cheap off of Amazon. Just put it above or behind your camera and it gives you some nice fill light that makes you look a little bit more alive and separates you from your background. On top of that, I also use these light boxes here. These give off a ton of light. It's soft light. I use these to light a whole green screen so that I can walk across it and not get lost in any shadows. On top of that, kind of an extra, we also have these little guys. These are like little spotlights that you can fill in any shadows. There's also like gels that you can put in there too to give a little bit of a color splash. I use a combination of those three to light depending on the situation. Next, let's talk about your webcam. There are tons of different webcams out there. You can even use like professional grade cameras and hook them up to your setup. My big pet peeve is to make sure that your camera is eye level. So what I do is I put my webcam on an arm that I can move around wherever I want. And sometimes I put it in front of the content that I'm presenting so that I can look beyond it. And it looks like I'm looking my audience directly in the eye, which is important. So many times nowadays when we're in meetings, this is what it looks like. And this is not engaging. This doesn't inspire trust. This doesn't bring connection. Instead, if we put our content, if we put our camera at eye level, it looks like we're actually talking to people and not off to the side, right down the barrel. Third, let's talk about audio. My favorite purchase, I would say in the past like 5 years, has been this guy. It's a little Bluetooth puck from Jabra. You can plug it in via USB as well. This has great sound for conference calls if you're in a room with a group of people, which when was the last time that happened? But this is basically like a speakerphone on steroids. It has a mute button built in as well, so you don't have to worry and scramble about getting on or off mute. You can just tap this button right up here and it takes you on and off mute. I love this piece of equipment. Whenever I'm joining audio for a Zoom meeting, I always call in using a phone because I feel like the connection is a little bit more reliable. If you have a hiccup in your Wi-Fi or someone's hogging the bandwidth, you don't have to worry about sounding like a robot or your audio cutting out. Yes, there is a slight delay, but there's so many pros to having that consistent connection versus relying on sometimes iffy Wi-Fi. Now, if you're working someplace where you can't like use speakerphone all the time, I would recommend getting, you know, maybe some good AirPods. Otherwise, there's like the like some good USB microphones as well, like the Blue Yeti here. Those are some options that you have to upgrade your audio experience. Next, we'll talk about the green screen. Obviously, you know the benefits if you watched my last video when we dug into Open Broadcaster software, where you can use this to put yourself in any setting that you want. So you've got slides that you can point to. I have mine on a nice little retractable roller, really easy to install. And when I need it, I pull it down. When I don't need it, it retracts and I can access whatever I have behind it. One thing to note about green screens, you want to make sure you light them and yourself really well. That makes the process of removing it in software so much easier. So lots and lots of lights. Final thing that I'll talk about is something that I haven't used too much, but it is pretty useful. It's this HDMI capture card. If you want to plug in a gaming system, TV receiver, whatever it is, you can plug this in and share it through OBS. Really helpful in certain scenarios. I haven't used this too much, like I've said, but there are a lot of streamers and presenters who have. So I'll link all of the equipment that I use down below. None of it's really top of the line. I don't necessarily know if it's like the best solution, but it's what works in my space and for what I'm presenting. That's all for now. Thank you for watching and catch you in the next one.